Now we'll move to lesson number 5, subject and verb agreement. Subject should always match with verb. When the subject of a verb is singular, the verb also must be in singular. But when the subject of the verb is plural, the verb is also plural. For that, you should know which is the subject and which is the verb. Here, my friend likes to play cricket. Which is the subject? My friend. My friend. Here, friends are not written. Friends is not written. Here, singular noun. So, my friends, the subject is singular. That is why it followed with singular verb. Likes. It is not like here. My friend likes to play. It's a wrong sentence. My friend likes to play cricket. Because friend is a singular subject, that is why likes is a singular verb we can use in the sentence. While you study the other sentence, when the subject of the verb is plural, the verb must also be plural. My friends like to play chess. Here friends is a plural noun, more than one friend. So it always followed with plural verb, like, it likes name. My friends likes to play chess. No, it's wrong sentence. My friends like to play chess. Friends is a plural subject. That is why like is a plural verb we used in the sentence. When the subject is one of the followed by plural noun, the verb is singular. I repeat, when the subject, which is the subject? Friend. One of the, when it is starting from with the words, one of the followed by a plural noun, that is friend, friends is a noun, the verb is singular. Here I have written likes. I have not written here like because the noun is plural and it is starting at one of my. So when one of my friends likes swimming. Next, a lot and plenty of takes plural verb when they denote number. In the beginning of the sentence or in the middle of the sentence, when you find a lot or plenty of words, they denote that they take a singular verb when they denote quantity or amount. There were a lot of, here a lot came, a lot of people, people is plural now, at the concert. There were, here where is a plural verb. There were a lot of people at the concert because I have not written here was, because people is a plural noun. There is a lot of water available. Lot of water available. It carries a singular verb because it shows the quantity or amount. Next, a singular collective noun takes a singular verb. Collective noun you all know. A crowd of people, here in your textbook, some of them are given. I am reading, you pay attention in your book. There was a crowd of people in the street. Here, crowd of people is a collective noun. It is followed with was. There was a crowd of people, not where. A gang of thieves is a collective noun. So, a gang of thieves was, not where, because it is counted as a singular word. A new board of directors has been elected, not have been elected. So here I have written that a singular collective noun takes a singular verb and not plural. Now we'll look to the some another examples. A pair of, when applied to things like scissors, shoes, trousers, where two components. Scissors have two components. Shoes have two components. Trousers have two components. Are always thought of as a single unit and so takes a singular verb. There is a new pair of shoes. pair of shoes, though it has two component, but it is counted as one unit. That is why we put a singular verb is. But when we, this remember it carefully, but when we omit the words a pair of, here I have written a pair of, but when we omit the words a pair of and only use the plural word, then it takes a plural verb. See the example, the scissors. Now here scissors have two components, but we have omitted the words a pair of. A pair of scissors are in the drawer, it's wrong. Because we have omitted the words a pair of, now this scissors, it becomes plural now. So it followed with a plural verb are. The scissors are in the drawers. This is a new pair of shoes. There was a pair of trousers in the laundry. So this way we can use the verb according to its subject. Next is class names or categories. Class names and categories such as clothing, footwear, crockery, cutlery, furniture, stationery are singular. It is always counted as singular and must therefore take a singular verb. We cannot say furnitures. There is a beautiful furnitures in my house, we don't say. Whether it is two chair or three chairs or two tables, it is always counted as a single unit. So how we write? The furniture in her house was beautiful, not were beautiful. Similar way, the next sentence we will say that the stationery used in our office is of poor quality. Here stationery, stationery, whether there are two pencils or a single pencil or rubber scale, whatever are there, stationery. So this stationery is always counted as a single unit, and that is why it is followed with a singular verb. The stationery used in our office is of poor quality. The next is news. In assembly, generally we say the students who are conducting assembly, they say today's news headlines. Whether it is one news or more than one, it is always said in plural, news. News, though it is in plural form, is always treated as singular. Is always treated as singular. Example, what is the latest news? Whether it is a single news or more than one, we always say news. What is the latest news? So news always carries a singular verb. No news is good news. This is another sentence I have not written, but no news is no news. So here also no news and oh no means there is no news is also a no news. So here also it carries with a singular verb. The second is we can say advice. Plural form is always treated as singular, while advice and information are never used in plural. Whether one advice or more than one. Teacher gave advice to the students. There is a lot of information given in the today's newspaper. So here, whether it is one advice or more than one advice, are never used in plural. We cannot say advices, informations. We cannot say like this. He gave me a lot of good advice. There is a plenty of information. So here it carries with a singular verb. Some of, half of, take a plural verb, refers to the amount or quantity, is singular and takes a singular verb. It is given in your textbook. You can refer your textbook as well. So some of or half of, and any other fraction, one third or one fourth. These are fractions. Sum of, half of, these are fractions. Takes a plural verb because here it is counted as more than one verb. Plural verb, if the reference is to number, to things that are countable, if we count that particular noun, then it carries a plural verb. But a singular verb, if the referent is amount or quantity. We'll make it more clear. Some of the houses were dark and dingy. Here, some of. There are many houses. After that, some houses, maybe two or three out of 10. So here, it takes a plural verb, where. Some of the houses were dark and dingy. Well, you see the another sentence, study the another one. Half of the eggs were rotten. Half of the land was barren. Here half of the word is given, but land, we never say lands. So half of the land, here we are talking about any one land. So it carries with a singular verb, was. Okay, next is many. Word many refers to a number, takes plural verb. Like many of the flowers have no spell. Many takes plural verb because it is referred to more than one. Much refers to amount or quantity, takes singular verb. Much here the exact number is not shown. That is why it takes singular verb. Much of the court side was flooded. Here much word we have started with much, where exact number is not shown. That is why it is followed with a singular verb, was. When a plural number applies to distance, weight, taken as a whole, kilometer, kilogram, this is taken as one. Taken as a whole is treated as singular, takes a singular verb. 10 kilometers is not a great distance. Here, kilometer is taken as whole. Whether it is 10 kilometers, 15 kilometers, whether in India or any other part of the world, it is said to be kilometers only. So here, it is taken as whole or treated as a singular, takes a singular verb. There are many other examples are given. 200 grams of tea costs 85 rupees, not cost. Here it is written costs, C-O-S-T-S. So 10,000 rupees is a lot of money. Here money is a common noun and which is used for whether 10,000 or 20,000 or 2 lakhs. It is said money only. So it always carries with a singular verb, is. Next is, if the title of the book or names of the house or hotel is plural, it takes a singular verb. Suppose, for example, the Arabian Nights, it's the name of a story book. Here, nights, many stories are there, but it is the name of book in that many stories are there. So, name of the book followed with a singular verb. The Arabian Nights is, because it is a name of book. Then the next is, the Seven Sisters is situated on high land. Here the Seven Sisters, name of hotels, though the sisters plural name, but it is the name of hotel, that is why it is carried with a singular verb. Now the next last one is, the following takes singular verb in sentence. If this word comes in the sentence, it always takes a singular verb, like each, every, everybody, none, neither of, anybody, each of, everyone, everyone of, none of, either of, nobody. These words, when comes in the sentence, it always takes a singular verb. Some of them I have written. Each guest was garlanded at the entrance. Each guest, each was, not where. Neither of the boys has won a scholarship. Neither of the boys, out of no boys, neither of the boys means no one. So it carries a singular verb, has won a scholarship. Every one of the events was keenly contested. Here everyone, each one. That is why it carries a singular verb, was. None of the applicants was found fit for the job. None of the applicants means no applicant, no one was found fit for the job. So it also carries with a singular verb. So students, hope you all have understood the concept, verb, subject and verb agreement. Once again, I repeat what we will revise what we have learned. If the subject is singular, it always followed with a singular verb. If the subject is plural, then it always followed with a plural verb. The exercises we will upload on the website. You all write down in your Fun with Grammar textbook.